the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You are well. Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, all over the continent, wherever you are. May the Lord bless you and keep you. It is time for the lunch hour. We are reaching you live from the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Jesus Aokololo, Kampala, Uganda, where God is raising great people to transform their world by the word of God. Let us pray. You are Yahweh. Yeah. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Yeah. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega. You are Yahweh, Lord. You are Yahweh. Yeah. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh, the ancient of the day. You are Yahweh, the Jehovah Jireh. You are Yahweh, Jehovah Nissi. You are Yahweh, El Shaddai. You are Yahweh, King of Kings. You are Yahweh, the Lord of Lords. Let us begin to exalt His name, because He is the Alpha, He is Omega, He is the beginning, He is the end, He is Jehovah Rapha, He is Jehovah Nissi, He is the Almighty God, He is greater than the greatest, He is better than the best, He is higher than the highest, He is your Father, He is my Father, He is seated in the heaven, and the earth is full too, He is inside the affairs of the earth. Right from the heaven, let's begin to thank Him. He is the King of Kings, He is the Lord of Lords, He is Jehovah Jireh, He is Jehovah Nissi, He is the El Shaddai, He is Jehovah Samuel, He is the mighty in battle, He is the Jehovah Elohim, He is the Lord my Gilead, He is the Lord my Balm, He is your Lord your Balm. Father, we thank you, He is the Prince of Peace, He is the Prince of Peace, He is the Lord of Lords, He is the glory of the Ancient of Days. Father, we thank you, we bless your name. You are Yahweh, yeah. You are Yahweh, Jehovah Yahweh, you are Yahweh, Jehovah Elohim, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh. You are Yahweh, Ancient of Days, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega, you are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega, Lema Sundaraba, Father, you are Yahweh, Daddy will bless your name, because you are the Alpha, you are the Omega, you are the beginning, you are the end. Lord, we thank you, Lord, we thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your mercy that endures forever. Lamentations 3:22. If it's not by your mercy, we will have been consumed. Lamentations 22:23. Lamentations 3:22-23. Lamentations 3:22-23. If not by your mercy, we will have consumed. It is by your mercy we are alive today. We thank you for your mercy. We bless you for your mercy. Lift your voice and cry to God. Say, Father, I thank you for your mercy. I thank you for your mercy over my family. I thank you for your mercy over my spouse. I thank you for your mercy over my children. I thank you for your mercy over my family member extended. I thank you for your mercy over my business. I thank you for your mercy over my career. I thank you for your mercy over my Christian life. At this season, many people are backslidden. Many people are going to sin. But you thank God for His mercy. The mercy of the Lord that is still keeping you as a child of God, that is sustaining you. Say, Father, I thank you for your mercy. I thank you for your mercy. Many are going to adultery. Many are going to fornication because of this season. But God has kept you. He has kept me. Let's thank you for His mercy. His mercy endures forever. Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for your mercy. Your mercy over our life. You are Yahweh. We bless your name. We appreciate you, Lord. Father, we give you all the glory. We give you adoration. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for silencing the enemy upon our life. Thank you, Lord, Jehovah Jireh. Thank you, Lord Jehovah Nissi, my brother and sister, my father and mother that is listening to the sound of my voice, begin to share this as we begin to go to session in prayer. Begin to share this spirit. Share it right now, because very soon we are going to go into session in the session prayer. Let's begin to share it. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We bless your name. We magnify your name. You are the Jehovah Jireh. You are Jehovah Nissi. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We bless your name. Lord, we say, hallowed be thy name. In Jesus' name we give thanks. In Jesus' name we give thanks. In Jesus' name we give thanks. Brethren, the word of God say, He said in 1 John chapter 1, verse 7 to 9. 1 John chapter 7, He said, if we say we don't have sin, we are a liar. And the truth is not in us. But if you confess our sin, He's manifest merciful to forgive. I want not to cry because say, Father, please have mercy on me. I cannot claim I'm not saved. I cannot claim I'm perfect. It's only you that can justify. Say, Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me. Forgive all our sin. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Forgive all our sin this one. Every sin that will not allow prayer to be answered. Daddy, forgive all our sin. Le Buzaga, Beligosi, and Le Guzaga, Le Guzegele, sin of pride, sin of bitterness, sin of anger. Please have mercy. Let your blood avail for all. Let your blood avail for all. Again, every iniquity, every sin that will not allow prayer to answer. This evening, let your mercy be. Let your mercy be. Let your mercy be. Let your jahada, let your zegede, et de gidege, let your zegede, let your zaga, aligahadaga, et de gede. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. The first prayer we are going to pray this afternoon is to call on God for those who are trusting God for the food of home. We are going to call on God for those who are trusting the home. We are going to cry to God and say, my Father, my Savior, you said you have not made anyone barren. Father, as you read in your word, O Lord, in Exodus chapter 25, 26, Father, have mercy. Everyone that trusts in you for the food of home, that he made them fruitful, that he made them fruitful, make them fruitful, everyone that is trusting you for the food of home, that he made them fruitful in the name of Jesus. Make them fruitful in the name of Jesus. Make them fruitful, in the every blockade. Every blockade in the fallopian tube, we command the name of Jesus be clear. Every blockade in the fallopian tube, they've told you your problem is fallopian tube. The Lord cleared that fallopian tube in the name of Jesus. If fallopian tube will be a problem, people have been delivering without fallopian tube. We say you will carry that pregnancy, you will deliver that pregnancy. Even without fallopian tube, is that where the enemy is standing? In the name of Jesus, he said, you fallopian tube, hear the word of the Lord. You cannot stand the daughter of Zion from bringing fruit through this season. You cannot stand it against the daughter of Zion. For me, for the distance, the word of God said to us, he said, Genesis chapter 1, verse 20, he said, be fruitful. He said, be fruitful, be multiplied. Father, in the name of Jesus, everyone under the sun on this ministry this morning, this afternoon, this evening, that is trusting God for the fruit of womb in America, in Europe, in Uganda, all over the world, I command fruitfulness. I say, in the name of Jesus, be fruitful, in the name of Jesus, be fruitful, in the name of Jesus, be fruitful. There is somebody, you only have one child, only one son. It is season, because the Bible says be fruitful. Fruitfulness does not mean one child. I decree in the name of Jesus, and you have more this season, you have received power to be fruitful again. Have boys, have girls, have boys in the name of Jesus. In the name of, if you believe it, the Lord will do it for you. If I can see that woman, you have only one son, no daughter, that's the only child you have. I say in the name of Jesus, my God will make you fruitful. You have a daughter, you have a son, you have daughters in the name of Jesus. Let us alaga, let us shake it, let us shake it in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray. But by special grace of God, the Lord has been telling me that there's somebody with a cerebral problem. There's a child with a cerebral problem. Father, you are the Lord. We are the, you know how to take care. This is a child of glory. This child that has a cerebral problem. That when it comes to cerebral problem, oh Lord. Father, heal that boy. Whatever that boy needs, oh Lord, to be able to fulfill destiny. Father, do it in Jesus' name. They have carried this boy to several ways. It has failed. But I don't know, Lord, you are the Alpha, you are the Omega. You can do all things concerning this boy that has a glorious destiny. Father, help him. Help him to fulfill destiny. Heal him, Lord. Lay your mighty hand upon him. Let the bomb begin to fulfill destiny in the name of Jesus. Every hindrance on the way, be removed in Jesus' name. Be removed in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray for the men of those women who are trusting God for the womb. Now we are going to cry to God. Say, Father, as any man, as many men that they have told that you cannot father a child, Lord, have mercy on those men, Lord. Have those mercy. Increase their fertility level. Increase their sperm count. Le buzaga, le duzegede, le duzegalaga, e yudaliga, zeturiga, le tuzaga. I speak to you in the name of Jesus. You queen of the coast that has collected one somebody's sperm and say it will not be fruitful in the life, in the name of Jesus, because that man is now under the banner of Lord Jesus Christ. Today, in the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, whatever that belongs to him, that is virtual, you have taken over into the kingdom of darkness, that you have taken over under the sea, under the water, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. By the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I stand upon the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ and the mandate of heaven by the that gave unto me and the prophetic proclamation of Pastor E. Adeboye upon my life, that whatever I say go shall go, whatever I say go shall go on this existing authority. I speak to you, you queen of the ghost, queen of the ghost, you have ordered to the thumb that mouth. Spermatozoa, that he cannot be fruitful in the physical. In the name of Jesus, will recover his sperm. In the name of Jesus, any of his virtues that you held on to, will recover in Jesus' name. Will recover blood. Will declare fruitful. Will declare free. In the name of Jesus, le munda hindaka, le tuzeke, le duzaga liga, shebrudaga. Then thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. There is somebody here. Your case of being having sperm problem is because you had a glass yesterday, several years ago. You have a car accident several years ago. Because of that, it affected your manhood. They said that because of that, you have a low sperm count. The Lord God of labor, the Lord that healed, he will heal you. Whatever is insufficient in your body, whatever was lost in that accident that make you to have low sperm count, that don't make you not to be able to father a child, in the name of Jesus, by the Lord name of Jesus Christ, that is restored to you. That is restored to you. The virtue, the power of fertility is restored to that man. That man that has accident several years ago, because of that, you are damaged. Something happened to you. I say you are healed. You are healed in the name of Jesus. You are healed in the name of Jesus. You are healed in the name of Jesus. Everyone, thank you, Jesus. Lord, have mercy in the name of Jesus. Have mercy. Now, the Lord said there are some men here. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. It's your service. We give you all the glory. Say there are some men here because of the bad moral life you have lived in the past. Because of bad moral life you have lived in the past, you have caused some sexual transmitted disease that affected your spermatozoa. We are going to cry for mercy. Say, Lord Jesus, have mercy on this man. Have mercy on this man. This man that be involved in various immoral affairs with different kind of women, they have sexual transmitted disease that's now affecting them for being fertile. Father, please have mercy. Please have mercy. Have mercy. Thank you, Jesus. There's a particular man that even the wife is, when you met your wife was a virgin, and you have been involved in very, very many bad relationship that you are involved in sexual transmission because of this woman who has presented herself only as a virgin before until the day of her marriage. Lord, please have mercy. Have mercy on this man. Have mercy on this man. Lord, have mercy. Let every relationship depart that is standing between and his marriage and his maternity, let it be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Let it be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We are still praying. We are going to lift our voice and cry unto God for the children this season. We are going to cry for the children. The Bible says in Psalm 127, verse 3, Psalm 127, it says, children are the rector of God, the food of God are their reward. We are going to cry for our children. Say, Father, in this season, preserve our children. Preserve our children. Preserve them from every sickness, from every disease. Preserve our children. Preserve them. Preserve them, Malia Dogoshe. Father, preserve our children. Preserve them, Lord. Preserve them, Lord. Preserve them from every terminal sickness, from every terminal disease, from every terminal sickness. Father, preserve these children in the name of Jesus. My Father, my God. My Father, my God. We will not bury any of our children in the name of Jesus. We will not bury any of our children in the name of Jesus. Zebri Dogo, Leduja Naga, Leduzeke Diga, Leduzika Duga. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. There is a child who has gone to the age that should be sitting down, is not sitting down. I speak in the name of Jesus. Let the healing power of God come upon that child. That child begin to sit down now. That child has got to hate. He should be sitting down now. It's about that age. That child cannot sit down. I command in the name of Jesus. You child begin to sit down now. Begin to sit down now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Daddy, we thank you for healing upon that child. Thank you, Lord, because that child begin to sit down now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We are still praying for children. We are going to lift our voice for every child, oh Lord, with one disability and the other. Every mother with a disabled child, we are going to ask God to have the healing and power of God to come upon all disabled children. Father, in the name of Jesus, every children with disability that you have not spoken the word of God to us this afternoon, Father, lay your healing upon those children. I don't know the kind of disability those children have, and the one that we have not mentioned, but you know, oh Lord, every child with a disability, that every child that is below 15 with disability, Father, lay your healing hand upon this children, Lord. Lay your healing hand upon this children, Lord. Send this children, oh, thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Some bones are coming together now. I see some children with a bone problem. The bones are coming together. God is reworking the bone. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God is reworking bones. Bones are being reworked. Some children with a bone problem. Bones are, oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for reworking this bone. Lord, we give you all the glory. Every child with a bone problem, you are healing in Jesus' name. The healing power of God is upon you. The Lord is straightening your leg. He's healing your bone. Every bending bone is made perfect in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Lord of God. Thank you, ancient God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, we are going to pray lastly for the children. Once prayer, one prayer. The Lord ministered to me this morning as I prepare for this service that we should pray for children that came in either earlier, maybe they call them premature baby, or children that have delay. We are going to cry to God that in their life, this will not affect them. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every child that was born prematurely, every child that was born very late, that exceeded 9 months, Father, please have mercy on those children. Whatever the enemy is planning against them in future, by the reason of this delay or early coming out, Father, we counsel them by the glory of Jesus. That we notify them by the glory of Jesus. We decree for those children that are born after 9 months, there shall be no delay in their life. They will not experience delay in every area of their life. In the name of Jesus, you have mercy on them. Lord, have mercy on them. In the name of Jesus, Lebuza Liga, Letuziga Librose, Letushegede, Letuzegelebo. Thank you, Jesus. You are young. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Malia Duga. Thank you, Holy Spirit. There's somebody here now. You have something under your neck. There's kind of an attachment, a kind of a swelling at your neck. Now, at the back of your neck, not on the front of your neck, I can see the healing. It's like the thing on that back of your neck is like an insect that's attached to that neck. It comes in form of a swelling. The Lord, I speak to you in the name of God. Every swelling at the back of your neck, the healing power goes upon them in Jesus' name. Every demonic attachment to cause you discomfort, I say in the name of Jesus, you are healed. In the name of Jesus, you are healed. In the name of Jesus, you are healed. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Lord of Lord. Thank you, ancient of day. Lord, we bless your name. Daddy, we give you all the glory. We give you adoration. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Malika said the name. You are worthy, Lord. Makalika Yaga. You are worthy, Lord. Elida Tugala. You are worthy, Lord. Mashendelia Bosuda. You are worthy, Lord. Makuri Gasekede. You are worthy, Lord. Makaliki City. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Makali go to the level. You are worthy, Lord. Mashendeli go to the level. You are worthy, Lord. Makaduriaga. You are worthy, Lord. Makalege Sekede. You are worthy, Lord. Galege to Sekede. You are worthy, Lord. Makadaliga Tuga. You are worthy, Lord. Makuri. You are worthy, Lord. Angels are singing. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, oh Lord. Angels are singing. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are singing. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord. Mali Bosu. You are worthy, Lord. Magali Bosuda. You are worthy, Lord. Makali Bosude. You are worthy, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Lord, we want to thank you. In Jesus' name we worship. We are going to lift our voice and cry to heaven and say, my Father, my Father, my Father, my Father, my Savior, my Savior. This is the seventh month of the year. Lord, have mercy on me. Every good thing you have started in my life, let there be completion, Lord. Let there be completion, Lord. Every good thing you have started in my life, let there be completion. Let me in the name of Jesus. Every good thing you have started in my life, let there be completion. Zebrido liga to say, le dujida liga suda, eluta liga suda yan, le dugariga selebo. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We are going to pray this prayer as received by the Holy from the Holy Spirit. I see somebody there padlocking his mouth. I don't know the meaning. I don't know the meaning of that person. That's the meaning. But I saw somebody's mouth being padlocked. You are going to cry to the heaven. I saw somebody they put the padlock on his mouth. God, what does this mean? You are going to cry. Say, Father. Yes, thank you, Jesus. You are going to say, Father. Say, my Father, my Father. Every demonic padlock on my mouth to make sure my voice will not be heard. In the name of Jesus, you are a liar. Satanic padlock be roasted by fire. Yakata yaka. Every demonic padlock upon our mouth, Lord. Upon our mouth, Lord, so that our voice will not be here. In the name of Jesus, you demonic padlock be roasted by fire. In the demonic padlock be roasted by fire. In the name of Jesus, our voice shall be heard. Your voice shall be heard. Your voice of your father was not heard. Your voice of your mother was not. My voice will be heard. Your voice will be heard. In the name of Jesus, every voice, every mouth have been padlocked. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the revelation. You are going to pray. The enemy, the Lord told me, said, there are some of you, some of you under the sound of the voice this morning, that you are the first child in the family. But because you don't have money, you cannot talk. They don't even really respect you. You are going to cry to them. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, whatever in my life is make my voice not be heard, either material prosperity or whatever anything, Father, give me an abundance. Let my voice be heard in the name of Jesus. Everyone under the sound of our voice in this afternoon, that their voice is not heard because of lack of financial prosperity. Father, please prosper them. Prosper us in Jesus' name. Our voice shall be heard. Our voice shall be heard. Your voice shall be heard in the business circle, in their career, in your family. Our voice shall be heard. Every demonic platform, every witchcraft platform, be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. Be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. Let tous da gada, let tous see gada ga, let go. Pray. Every demonic platform that is holding my mouth in the name of Jesus, holding your mouth, be roasted by fire. Be roasted by fire. Demonic platform holding our mouth, not our voice will be heard. In the workplace, be roasted by fire. In the name of Jesus, let us the river. Let thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Now, the Lord is telling me, in the workplace, you are the boss. But because you are not meeting your targets, other people that are meeting their targets, they can talk, but you cannot talk. You are going to leave and say, Father, give me power to deliver results, to achieve my target, so that my voice can be heard. Father, my Father, my Father, my Savior, give me the power to deliver results, to achieve my target, to exceed my target, so that my voice can be heard. My voice can be heard in the name of Jesus. Our voice shall be heard. Our voice shall be heard in the name of Jesus. Our voice shall be heard. That person in the workplace, your voice shall be heard. You begin to meet your target. You begin to exceed your target. Holy Spirit will help you. Power of the Most High God will support you in the name of Jesus. Let you share. Let you hear the God. Let you hear the God. Let you see 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 the God. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. I'm seeing a trend right now. I'm seeing a trend being passed from one long end to another end. And I'm asking God, what is the meaning of this trend? You are going to cry to God. Say, my Father, my Father. Every demonic rope, to tie my destiny down in the name of Jesus. Catch fire! Every demonic rope to tie me down, to tie my destiny down. Catch fire in Jesus' name. Every demonic rope ancestral rule, tie not to exchange family DNA. Be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. Be roasted by fire. We say the Son of God has set us free. We are free. We are free in the name of Jesus. Let you shedega, let you zegedege, let you zagada, let you zagadege, let you zagada, let you shiga, let you hidaga, let you zegede, let you zegede. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to round up now as we go to the wall. We are going to pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are going to cry to God. Say, Father, every personality in form of demonic act appearing to me, handling the money in the night, in the name of Jesus, we command that demonic act in the name of Jesus be roasted by fire. Every demonic act sent on an errand to monitor your future, to monitor your destiny, in the name of Jesus, be roasted by fire. Every demonic act sent from the village, sent from anywhere in the world, to be monitoring your progress, to be monitoring your life, to monitor your next level of your life, in the name of Jesus, you demonic act, be roasted by fire, in the name of Jesus. Ancient car, be roasted by fire, in the name of Jesus. Let you say God. Let us get it. Let us get it. Let us have that. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. My Father, we are grateful. Oh Lord, we are grateful, Lord. We are grateful. Oh Lord, for all you have done for us. Hallelujah. We are grateful. Hallelujah, he is Lord, amen, he has risen from the dead, he is Lord, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Every limitation to your people receiving the blessing here, every in the internet, and I command the limitation, be roasted by fire in Jesus' name, every embargo, every interest, to people attending and working online, as the embargo be lifted in Jesus' name. Father, Holy Spirit of God, envelope this service. Power of the Most High God, envelope this service. I yield my fire of God, envelope this service. I yield myself unto you, Lord. Touch my lips, touch my tongue. Let me not speak any word of my own. Holy Spirit, speak through me. Father, Lord, speak through me, O Lord. Give your people understanding. Make them the hearer of the word and the doer of the word. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Good afternoon once again. Good morning, good evening. Whichever time horizon you have all over the world, we're still reaching you live from the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Jesus, out Kololo, Kampala, Uganda, where God is raising great people to transform their world by the word of God. Amen. We are talking about let the fire fall, part four. 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 If we're taking our scripture from Exodus chapter 3, Exodus chapter 3, and verse 1 to 6. Exodus chapter 3, verse 1 to 6. Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, of his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he led the flock to the backside of the desert, and came to the mountain of God, even unto Aaron. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of the bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire. The bush was not consumed. Verse 3. And Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burned. And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see God, called unto him out of the midst of the bush, and said, Moses, Moses, he said, here I am. And he said, draw not near, put off thy shoe from thy feet, for the place where thou standest is holy ground. Moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. Amen. When we started this series some months ago, we said, let the fire fall. Let the fire fall. Connote three things. We said, when we talk about, we said, fire, we said the word of God. Holy Spirit is represented by three things. Holy Spirit of God is represented by three things. Number one, Holy Spirit is represented by water. We said John chapter 7, 37 to 39. Holy Spirit is represented by water. John 7, 37 to 39. We said Holy Spirit is represented by wind. Ezekiel 37, 1 to 10. Ezekiel chapter 7, 1 to 10. Ezekiel chapter 37, 1 to 10. Those things represented by wind. Acts chapter 2, verse 2. Acts chapter 2, verse 2. Acts chapter 2, verse 2. We said, Holy Spirit is represented by fire. Holy Spirit is represented by fire. Holy Spirit is represented by fire. Judges chapter 15, 11 to 16. Judges chapter 15, 11 to 16. 1 Kings chapter 18, 36 to 40. 1 Kings chapter 18, 36 to 40. 1 Kings chapter 18, 36 to 40. Acts chapter 2, 3 to 6. Acts chapter 2, 3 to 6. Acts chapter 2, 3 to 6. In these 3 instances, the Holy Spirit, fire came down, and fire symbolizing the Holy Spirit. There's the Holy Spirit. So we said, when we talk about let the fire fall, what are we talking about? We said, let the Holy Spirit come down. We said, when the fire fall, let the presence of God come down. Let the fire fall. Mean let the power of the Holy Spirit, let the Holy Spirit come down. Let the Holy Spirit come down. Let the fire fall. Let the power of God come down. Let the fire fall. Let the presence of God come down. And brethren, this today, we are going on this part, fourth session, to say, let the fire fall and destroy every demonic foundation of my life. Let the fire fall and destroy every demonic foundation of my life. In Psalm 11, verse 3. Psalm 11, verse 3. Psalm 11, verse 3. It says, if the foundation be destroyed, what will the righteous do? If the foundation be destroyed, what will the righteous be do? Now, brethren, in the scripture we read, Exodus chapter 3. Exodus chapter 3, verse 1 to 6. That was the first time the fire fell from heaven. And when the fire fell this time around, it fell to repair somebody's foundation. And the foundation of that man was to Moses. The fire fell to repair the foundation of Moses, the manager of life of Moses. Recall that in Genesis, in Exodus chapter 1, Exodus from verse 9 to 18, the story, we were told of the story of that after the death of Joseph, after the death of Joseph, there arose a new king, a new pharaoh in the land that does not know the children of Israel, who now thought that, who felt that the children of Israel being around will eventually take over the land by colluding with their enemy. So this, so because of that, Moses coming was actually supposed not to, was characterized by a plan to make sure he did not come or he's killed. So it was during this period, Moses coming was characterized by laws, by decree, to either kill him or to make sure he did not come. So the law was issued that every child of Hebrew should be killed when it's a male child. Every child of Hebrew should be killed when it's a male child. Every child of Hebrew should be killed when it's a male child. So when Moses came, because of the mercy of the Lord, Moses' mother had him. He was a male child. They took him to the river. The mercy of the Lord worked for him. And Moses was taken by Pharaoh's daughter. He was lost by the Pharaoh's daughter. He was taken down by that daughter. But because there was a foundation in the life of Moses, Moses was born by the father and the mother who are from the highly temperamental family. Moses was born by a father of a temperamental family. Maybe before I go further, let me ask you, what is the foundation? Foundation is what I can call basically the bedrock of any life. It's a bedrock of a building. Foundation is the structure underpinning a building. Foundation is that lowest bearing part of the building. It's that thing that at the bottom of a building. Is that supporting structure that supports a building. So when we are talking about foundation for every child of God, we are talking about his background. We are talking about how he was born. The circumstances around his back. We are talking about where was his, what is his generation? What is his genealogy? What is his lineage? That's what we are talking about. So in the case of Moses in Genesis chapter 2 was born by a mother and a father of Levite. And remember Levi in Genesis chapter 49. Genesis chapter 49, verse 5 to 7. Genesis chapter 49, 5 to 7. Jacob cursed Levi and Simon because they said he said they have bad temper. And he cursed them that they will live their life in anger and temper. So Moses was born from the foundation, from a structure, from two parents who are both highly temperamental. That was bad. So by Exodus chapter 2, but the mercy of the Lord, because of the plan of God for his life, it was the daughter of Pharaoh that picked him up, otherwise he would have been killed. I was not seeing him. And on one day, Moses was going out and he saw people fighting. He saw Israelite and Hebrew. He tried to separate them, but he killed an Egyptian child. He was reported to Pharaoh. And Pharaoh was going to be ran away. So Moses spent 40 years of his life at the backside of his father's in-law. Moses spent 40 years by the, in fact, he spent 40 years with his father-in-law. That by the time this fire came first, Moses was already 80 years old. Moses was already 80 years old. He spent 40 years in his, with his father-in-law, at taking care of the father-in-law flock, Jethro, for 40 years. But when the fire fell, he repaired that foundation of Moses. That foundation of Moses that would have kept Moses at the backside of his father-in-law's farm for the rest of his life. The fire fell. There was a new beginning. The man that was forgotten was remembered. His foundation was repaired. And God gave him a new mandate. By the time you read the verse 10, God told him, now go to Egypt and go and deliver my people. I speak to somebody like today. Fire of God will fall on your foundation. I will repair every fault in it that want to stand against you and your advancement and your growth in the name of Jesus. The fire fell on Moses. It fell on his foundation and God spoke a word. Moses ran away as a fugitive and he went back as a prophet. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Whatever is chasing you away from the plan of God for your life, the fire of God will fall upon you today. I will repair it in Jesus' name. The fire of God will fall upon you today. I will repair in the name of Jesus. Fire fell. Fire of God fell. And the foundation of Moses' life was repaired. He was restored to the original plan of God. And he went to Egypt. And from Egypt, he delivered the people of God from Israel. However, that's where I'm going. I'd like to read to you something. And how does it connect? How does it connect with what we are going through now, with COVID-19 now? How does let the fire fall on my foundation on your fire on the COVID-19 we are going through now? I read Psalm 11 again. Psalm 11 verse 1 to 3. It says, He said, in the Lord do I put my trust. I'll say to my soul, flee as a bird to your mountain. For lo, the wicked bend their bow, they make ready their arrow upon the string, that they may quickly shoot at the upright in the heart. If the foundation be destroyed, what will the righteous do? What will the righteous do? The first definition of foundation I gave to you was from the conceptual meaning of foundation, the literary meaning of foundation, which is the bedrock of anything, with the bottom of any building, the bedrock of a building, the bottom of a building, the supporting structure of a building, that's a conceptual definition. However, there is what they call the metaphoric definition from the foundation. The metaphoric meaning of foundation. But before we go there, I'd like you to know in this foundation, in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 10, in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 10, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 10, the word of God said, there are several things people use to build foundation. He said, foundation can be built, that is the bottom of a building, can be built with the gold, you can use silver, you can use precious stones. He said, we can use wood, you can use hay, and you can use straw to build a foundation. And brethren, wood, hay, and raw. Wood, hay, and raw, and straw. Wood, hay, and straw. They are perishable items. They are perishable items. They are perishable structures. That when this thing come upon the, when the fire come upon the wood, it will burn the wood, and the wood will suffer loss. When the fire come upon the air, it will burn the air, and it will suffer loss. When the fire come upon the straw, it will burn the straw, and it will suffer loss. So wood, hay, and straw are synonymous with the foundation of idolatry. Wood, hay, and straw are synonymous with the foundation of idolatry. A foundation that idolatry can never, at this season, will support COVID-19 to destroy people. Everyone that is from an idolatry foundation, at this season, when working with the negative effect of COVID-19, it will destroy the business, that person will suffer a loss. The reason why we are praying and we are asking fire to fall on our foundation at this season is that every foundation of wood, hay, and straw are foundation of idolatry. They are temporary structure. They don't last. And in this season, they always align, they always cooperate with the COVID-19 or any storm, any fire to make sure the building does not stand. So, and that's why we must pray for everyone that's from the idolatry foundation, for for it is fabric of wood, made of straw, wouldn't eat in the name of Jesus. However, if a furniture that is made of stones, precious stone, gold and silver, when fire came, when every fire fall on it, on gold and silver, it made them to be purer. When fire fall on the gold and the silver and pure, it made them to be purer. So what I'm telling you today is that when you have a foundation of gold, of silver, of precious stone, when you are from a foundation of 3 generations, 4 generations, 5 generations, or some born again Christian, COVID-19 cannot do anything to you. Because you are standing on the foundation of good Lord Jesus Christ, which have been there for 3-4 generations. But when you are not sure of your foundation, we are not, you know your 3rd generation foundation is from very idolatry of fallen things. There are many of us this season are born again Christian, but we don't even know what happened in the village. We don't know what happened in the village. Some of us are born again Christian in the town, but in the village some people are making incantation and sorcery in our favor. That would work against COVID, work in support of COVID-19. And that's why we want to pray that let the fire fall. And every faulty foundation in our life, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Now, Psalm 11:1-3, I read to you. Psalm 11:1-3, I read to you. He said, it was a psalm of a David. David was being pursued by the enemy. And who is this enemy? This enemy is a man called Saul. And David, they were telling David, said, David, run to the mountain. David said, if I run to the mountain, the enemy Saul is already waiting for with bow, with arrow to shoot at me. Because why? He said, if the foundation of the soul, what do righteous do? Now, the foundation the enemy is talking about there is the supporting structures, is the system. Because at that time, Samuel was even afraid of of Saul. That Samuel was afraid of Saul. So when God told Samuel in 1 Samuel 16, he said, go and anoint and prepare a king for me in the lineage of Jesse. When Samuel had that, he was afraid. He said, Saul will kill me. Saul has become something else by that time. So that is why God is telling you and me to pray. So then he's not saying, what foundation are we talking about? Samuel is a prophet in the nation, but he can't do anything. Saul will kill him. The structure has been destroyed. So brethren, what am I talking about? In this season, at this season right now, the structures have been collapsed. This economic structure has been collapsed. Global economic structure has been collapsed. Everything has scattered. So at this season, you need prayer. You need God to rebuild the structure. You need prayer to rebuild the structure. And that's why I want to pray. For many of us who doesn't believe, you don't believe, I'll quickly that on this thing, on this message, I will tell you in the scripture, there are situations of financial issue. Evidence of financial challenge. Elijah, in 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 1, he was not known. By 1 Kings chapter 19, 1-4, when Jezebel threatened him, you know what he said in verse 4? He said, oh Lord, take away my life, for I am not better than my father's. Who are his father? His father must belong to idolatry. Gideon was from idolatrous family. In Judges chapter 6, verse 25, God told Gideon, said, Gideon, you just have to go and destroy the altar of Baal in your father's house. If you want to do well in ministry. Unfortunately, God did tell Gideon, go and destroy the power God in your father's house. He didn't say he should do it in the night. He did it in the night because he was afraid. Because he was not supposed to do it during the day, they came to attack him later in life. By Judges chapter 8, the same man will come back to idolatry. So what am I saying? When family is not properly destroyed by fire, it comes back to afflict people. That will not be your portion in Jesus' name. When family is not properly set on fire and roasted, come back to destroy them. I've told you about the story of Moses. Moses came from a temperamental family. When the fire fell in Exodus chapter 3, he repaired his foundation to deliver the people of God from the land of the Egyptians. However, because the fire did not destroy that bad temper very well, that foundation of temper very well, by Numbers chapter 27-12, the same temper rose up again, truncated his ministry. That's his foundation. Now, I'm not telling you the evil things they know. If you go to Acts chapter 21, verse 9, there was a story there. They say a man called Deacon Philip has 4 daughters. And the 4 daughters are virgin and they are prophetess. The four daughters are virgins and they are prophetess. The four daughters are virgins and they are prophetess. Their father, the king Philip, was the first deacon in Israel. In Acts chapter 6, their father, Philip, was the first king, was the first deacon in Israel. In Acts chapter 6, verse 5, he was ordained among the first seven deacons in the land. So automatically, his daughter became prophetess because of the same grace that flowed into their life. The daughter had the foundation of holiness. Not only that, Timothy. Timothy was a child of God, was born again, is a pastor. But in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 15, 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 15, Paul said that he remembered Timothy, and the people should remember the faith that it is his mother Eunice and his grandmother Eunice. So Timothy's mother and grandmother, they are born again Christian. No wonder Timothy was able to do well in ministry, because he had a strong foundation of born again Christian and people who are faith, who have served God. Now, this is what foundation can do. So those of you who don't believe that I'm born again Christian, I don't need to pray our foundation, you can see. Now, when fire fall on foundation, two things happen. When fire fall on foundation, two things normally happen. Number one is that either when the fire fall, it destroys everything that's in that foundation, or at least some remnants are below. Now, what determines when fire fall, whether it will destroy all the impurity in the foundation, or what some little will be destroyed and left some? Basically, it's about your disposition. What is your attitude? What's your disposition? When fire fell for the first time, in Exodus chapter 3, to Moses, what Moses said? Moses did not embrace the fire. He was saying, this fire, let me look at it. It looked nice, so let me look at it. Moses did not recognize he has some bad structural foundation. He never knew that he left Egypt because of the fact that he was supposed to be a deliverer. He didn't even know anything about it. He was a father-in-law. He was so comfortable staying in his father-in-law's house, Jethro, and being a shepherd there. He was so comfortable because he didn't know what the future was for him. So it was God that was pressurizing him. He was even resisting the fire. God pressurized him. He gave several excuses. And because God had the kind of people of God, he had to send Moses. Because Moses did not embrace the fire, he did not know the purpose of the fire on his foundation. What the fire is supposed to do, he did not do fully. Unlike Paul, in Acts chapter 9, verse 1 to 9. What Paul, in the case of Paul, Paul was a vagabond. He was a bad man. He was a murderer. And he was going, fire fell. The presence of God came down. And Lord can ask Paul. He said, Paul, why thou persecuted me? And Saul said, who are you? And God said, I'm Jesus Christ. He said, you know the disposition of Paul? He said, God, what will you me do? What would you want me to do? That was the disposition of Paul. Paul was ready for fire to destroy everything that is not of God in his foundation. And God said, you go. There is a man and I am waiting for you. He will pray for you, he will teach you. So Paul was ready to embrace the fire. He knew what he was before, and that's why Paul finished very well and finished very strongly. So this morning, this afternoon, you are going to pray. Because you can either, the reason why many of us are going through so many things in life is our disposition. Many people don't believe in foundational issues. They say, no, I don't have a problem. I've been born again Christian, therefore I don't need anything again. So I need to just, no. But somebody that is saying this, you see, have a dream when you see yourself in villages, a certain period of time, you say you don't have any problem with foundation. You still have a regular dream of shame and terrible nightmare. You know you came from a related family. You are serving with specific problems that have been battling your life for years. People in your foundation. You know that women always have divorce or separated home. And they've been there, and you say you are born again and you don't need it. Amen. You have stubborn problems that you have been battling with. Your usual delay in your life, or you're, and you're still saying you don't need to deal with the foundation. You graduated with somebody, you go out first class, and you go employ the same organization. The person that you go out employ together, he has got to build houses, properties all over the world. You are strong to build only one house in Uganda or in your nation, and you say you don't need the problem, there's no problem with your foundation. Please wake up. Wake up. You need to pray. Pray God. So we are going to pray. God will not do anything what you and me can do. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. God himself will not do anything you and me supposed to do. There are certain things you should do, there's something I should do. And that's what we need to pray now. We are going to spend the next few minutes praying on our foundation. You are going to talk to God. I have told you why we are going to pray. That's what you're saying, when the foundation is your own righteous, the righteous must pray. There's only righteous can be called to pray. And you must pray because why? You don't want the powers of darkness. You don't want what COVID-19 is doing to align with the devil, demonic foundation, and begin to torment, to begin to disturb. In this season, whatever you like, anybody can say. Some people are still buying houses, are still building homes, are still building cars, are still doing new things. And some of them are not children of God. And you and me are children of God. Why not? We are going to rise up. Let's rise up. We are going to cry to God. Say, my Father, my Savior, set your fire on my foundation. Set your fire on my foundation and let every impurity be destroyed. In the name of Jesus, my Father, my Savior, set your fire on the foundation. Set your fire on the foundation. Let every impurity be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed. In the name of Jesus, let the shade again. Let do Zakala. In Jesus' name we pray. Before we continue, you are listening to this session this afternoon, and you are not surrendering your life to Jesus Christ, you need to pray. You need to surrender your life to Christ before you continue prayer. And you want to say, you want to give your life to Christ, say this prayer after and say, Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I boldly declare I am saved. I'm washed by the blood of Jesus. I am justified by the blood of Jesus. I am sanctified by the blood of Jesus. Now I'm not born again. In Jesus' name, amen. You pray this prayer after this sermon, please call us. We want to pray with you so that we can support you and prayerfully support you to go in the Christian. The rest of all, we are going to pray. In Mark chapter 3, verse 27, he said, who is that one that can enter the strong man house? I will not fall behind the strong man. You are going to cry. Say, Father, every strong man in form of idol of my father's house, loose over my life in Jesus' name. Every idol in form of strong man from my father's house, loose over my life, loose over my business, loose over my career, in the name of Jesus, le breche, in Jesus' name we pray. You are going to cry to God. Revelation 12:11, he said, we overcome by God and love and one of our testimony. Say, all consequence of him, say, Father, say, my Father, my Savior, all consequences of the worship of evil power of my father's house, I wipe you by blood. I wipe you by blood. Say, my Father, my Savior, all consequences of the worship of the evil power of my father's house, upon my future, upon my destiny, I wipe up by the blood of Jesus. I wipe up by the blood of Jesus. All consequences of the worship of evil power, of idols of my father's house, of my business, of my career, of my marriage, I wipe them up by the blood of Jesus. I wipe them up by the blood of Jesus. Because the word of God says, I overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. In the name of Jesus, let us say, revoche, je dege, dege, le dege. In Jesus' name we pray. Number three prayer. Some of the, as I said to you, the ancestral covenant. We are going to cry. And the word of God says, Philippians 2:9-10. Philippians chapter says, the Lord has given Jesus Christ a name that's above every name. The name of Jesus Christ, every name is above. Say, Father, I break off from my ancestral covenant with the power of my father's house, limiting my expansion, limiting my enlargement in the name of. Say, my Father, my Savior, I break off from every ancestral covenant of the power of my father's house, limiting our enlargement, limit our growth, limit our abundance in the name of Jesus. Let you say, Balege, let you shake it again, let you say, Gede, Hita, Yakala, Elego, in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. This, many of us, this evil power of your father's house, their agenda is to oppress, is to torment, is to render somebody useless. You are going to cry to God. Say, oppressive agenda. Psalm 16:1-3. Arise, O Lord, and let my enemies scatter. Say, oppressive agenda of the evil power of my father's house, speaking against my breakthrough, scatter! In the name of Jesus. My father, oppressive agenda of failure, of poverty, of demotion, of the evil power of my father's house, speaking against me and my breakthrough, scatter in Jesus' name. Scatter! 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 pray. Oppressive agenda of evil father of my father's house. Oppressive agenda of demotion, of failure, of poverty, of evil father of my father's house. Speaking against us and our breakthrough as in the name of Jesus. Scatter. In the name of Jesus. Scatter. Shakataka. Let the shake it. Let us shake it. Let us. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name, as I said, the whole agenda of this foundation is to war with COVID-19, poor economy, things are not working well, so that you can have a good excuse to realize that it is true, you know this COVID-19, business are down, they are not including people, there is no job, it's a lie. These are all the plans from the evil power of your father's house, to make you relax and not possess your possession. And you are going to cry to God. In Matthew chapter 18, verse 18, he said, God has told us, whatever we bind on earth is bind on earth. Whatever we lose on earth, is lose on earth. We are going to cry to God. Say, arrows of affliction, originating from my father, from idolatry of my father's house, supporting COVID-19 consequences, are to impact on me and my business. In the name of Jesus, I say, back to sender. Arrows of affliction, arrow of business failure, arrow of joblessness, arrow of disease, from my father's house, working with COVID-19. He said, I say, back to sender. Arrow of failure, arrow of joblessness, arrow of poverty, arrow of demotion, arrow of business failure, arrow of poverty, arrow of scarcity, arrow of singleness, the coming from the family of my father's house, walking with COVID-19. I say, in the name of Jesus, back to sender, in the name of Jesus, back to sender, let you say the book, let it get again, in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Brother, we are praying this morning. When I prayed, the Lord told me this last prayer is very important. He said there are many of us, we are in town, we are in city. Some people are doing certain things to protect us in the village, and we don't know. So we are going to cry to God. Number 23. He said there shall be no enchantment or divination against the household of Israel. Because now we see what the Lord has done. Number 23. There shall be no enchantment or divination against the household of Jacob. Now we see what the Lord has done. He said, so every satanic priest in my father's house, from my village, ministering negativity to my heart, ministering against me, in the name of Jesus, become null and void, be returned. Every satanic priest in my father's house, ministering failure, ministering anything, ministering sorcery, enchantment, divination against me, in the name of Jesus, render null and void. In the name of Jesus, render null and void. In the name of Jesus, render null and void. In the name of Jesus, Zedelebo, Ledo Zegede, Ledegede, Zegede. In Jesus' name we pray. It is this power, when this power that walk with COVID-19, that will make us say, oh, sorry. This is it. We don't have, there is no space because you can see what is going on, that the COVID-19. Meanwhile, some people are getting jobs, some people are getting contracts. They put garment of opposition. In first Corinthians 6:19, say, build an effectual that will be open. First Corinthians 16:9, say, build an effectual that will be open to me, but they are many adversaries. First Corinthians 16:9. A great and effective that God, but there are many great adversaries. We are going to cry to God. Say, garment of opposition, designed by the evil power of my father's house, against my breakthrough, in the name of Jesus, be roasted! Garment of opposition, walk with COVID-19 challenges, against my breakthrough, be roasted by fire, Jesus' name, be roasted by fire, Jesus' name, be roasted, be roasted, be roasted, be roasted, in the name of Jesus. Garment of opposition, garment of rejection, garment of disfavor, from my father's house, walking with COVID-19, so I want to walk against all. Be roasted by fire, in the name of Jesus, be roasted by fire, garment of shame, garment of disgrace, for my father, that walking with COVID-19. fighting to go against the breakthrough, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire, be roasted by fire. Elia to Gala, Zadale, Elege, Elia Taka, Sheliga Saka, Kabeka Saka, Yegege Seke, Rotoko Seke, Elege Seke, open door. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to cry and say, Father, from this area, the open door for me. Open door, open door. Everywhere I go, open door, open door, open door. Kalida Sida, open door, open door. Let you shake it again. Every great good door will command to open by force of heaven. Jesus said, be opened by force, by fire. Every great door will command to open by force, by fire, by force, by fire. In the name of Jesus, Kalata Sidi. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Malika Sidele. Let us say, Kene Bozo. Let us say, Adelia Togo. Let us say, Yaka. Kaduria Daga. Eliga Sidi. Let us say, Kene. Eliga Daga. You are Yahweh. The ancient of day. You are Yahweh. Jehovah Nissi. You are Yahweh. Almighty God. You are Yahweh. Malika Sidele. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we just want to thank you. Oh Lord, we thank you today. Little Sagoda, little Zagalaga. Father, let your fire fall. I like you to lift and say, Father, let your fire fall. Every fault in the family of the people, let your fire fall and rust there in every limitation, every limitation in their life. Let your fire fall and rust every debris, every fault in their foundation, every delay, every embargo. Let your fire fall and rust every delay and remove every embargo. In the name of Jesus, lift up from this season, in the name of Jesus, we embrace fire. We embrace fire. We embrace fire. Fire to purify your foundation, to remove every debris, to remove every debris in that foundation, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In the name that's appeared over him, in the name of Jesus. Your family is set on fire now. Amen. Your family is set on fire now. Your family is set on fire. Your family is set on fire. In the name of Jesus, your family is set on fire to destroy debris, to remove impurities. In the name of Jesus, your family is free from delay. In the name of your family is free from embargo. Your family is free from every negativity, from every hatred, from every shame, from every disgrace. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Mm. Father, we just want to thank you once again. Thank you for the foundation you are repairing. Thank you for those who have been remembered now. Thank you, Lord, for every delay that will remove, embargo that will remove. Thank you, Lord, for the foundation that will be replaced with the foundation of Jesus Christ, with the gold foundation, with the silver foundation, with the precious foundation. Mm. Foundation. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for, because no more loss again. Because there is no more loss again. And then I come to losses in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we lift up our offering to you in the name of Jesus. Please accept it from us in Jesus' name. Lend me from the beginning of your gospel to the glory of your name. In Jesus' name we pray. We want to thank you so much for listening to this telecast. I want to trust God that you will be mightily blessed today. Please, tomorrow is another day. It's a prayer meeting at 6:30. Tomorrow is another meeting at 6:30 p.m. It's a time to pray. We are continuing this prayer. Let the fire fall. Last week was glorious. Tomorrow will be great, more super glorious in the name of Jesus. If you have been blessed by this testing, by this sermon today, I'd like you to please encourage you to go to our Facebook, our social media page. Go to our social media page. You can go to our social media page. Our YouTube page is called How CC Jesus Out Kampala. How CC Jesus Out Kampala. You can subscribe to it. You can like it. You can share it. Now, go to our Facebook page called How CC Jesus Out Youth. How CC Jesus Out Youth Facebook. You can follow us on the page. Like us on the page. Share of the page. And comment on the page. And as you are doing this, you are proclaiming the gospel. Go to our Instagram page. It's called at RCCD Kampala. Our Instagram is at RCCD Kampala. Our Twitter page is at RCCD Kololo UG. At RCCD Kololo UG. And as you do spread this gospel and you share, And please follow us on all our pages so that anytime we have a program, we have automatic notification. The Lord will be with you. The Lord will keep you. The Lord cause us to shine upon you. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Till I see you tomorrow, the Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. Cause us to shine upon you in Jesus' name.